The credit card bubble in America is on the verge of popping, and the way we know this is because the credit card default rates are skyrocketing.
Prices keep rising in America, and policymakers are asking how the central bank could let this happen.
In a country that prides itself on openness and responsibility, a concerning reality has emerged. The actual state of the U.S. economy may be significantly worse than what official reports suggest. Recent reports have raised concerns about the nation's financial stability. These reports have challenged the optimistic projections and cautious hope that have been dominant. The warning signs are increasing and point toward an economy that could be on the edge of a crisis. This crisis could have far-reaching implications for both households and businesses. Among the concerns are stagnant wage growth and skyrocketing consumer debt. With the November elections approaching, these reports have raised red flags and have severe economic implications. The recent reports about the United States economy have raised some serious concerns. Despite the positive outlook presented by the White House, new findings indicate that the economic situation may be much worse than we have been led to believe. Three distinct government reports have raised concerns about the U.S. economy and hinted that it might be in a severe and prolonged recession by the time of the November elections. One of these reports from the Philly Fed sheds light on consumer behavior, particularly regarding credit card usage. At first glance, the credit card data may seem promising as balances are approaching pre-pandemic levels. However, a closer look reveals a worrisome trend. Consumers increasingly rely on credit cards to make ends meet, possibly due to inflation surpassing wage growth. This means that while nominal credit card balances are soaring, real account balances adjusted for inflation remain below pre-pandemic levels. This suggests that consumers are struggling to keep up with rising costs. In addition, the performance of credit cards is not very good. The debt rates are increasing, indicating that more people cannot make their payments on time. This is particularly concerning as it suggests that consumers are not very confident about their financial future and may be experiencing significant economic difficulties. Furthermore, the housing market, which is often a good indicator of economic health, also shows signs of weakness. The sales of existing homes have significantly decreased, and even the sales of new homes are struggling. Builders have a high inventory of unsold homes, similar to the situation before the financial crisis of 2008. This oversupply could lead to price reductions, making the situation even more difficult for homeowners. Additionally, the latest Beige Book report from the Fed contradicts the description of robust economic growth. Despite surging wages, consumer spending remains poor, especially in discretionary categories. This suggests that while wages may be increasing, they are not keeping pace with inflation, leaving consumers with less purchasing power. Furthermore, rising energy prices and insurance rates are eating into consumers' discretionary spending, further dampening economic prospects. Firms are finding it increasingly difficult to pass on cost increases to consumers, resulting in squeezed profit margins. The U.S. economy is facing challenges and vulnerabilities despite positive headline data. According to the Beige Book report, consumer spending, which makes up 70% of economic growth, showed very little change. This weak performance is worrying, especially given the ongoing problem of consumers struggling to keep up with inflation. Despite claims of a strong labor market, evidence suggests otherwise. If the job market were truly as strong as it is claimed to be, we would expect to see a corresponding increase in consumer spending, which we are simply not seeing. Discretionary spending in particular remains weak as consumers struggle with increased prices, worsened by rising energy costs. These rising expenses eat into discretionary budgets, leading to sluggish sales in sectors like auto buying. Despite reports of soaring wages, the reality is more nuanced. While some districts reported wage growth returning to historical averages, the discrepancy between wage gains and actual spending raises eyebrows. Moreover, firms are finding it increasingly challenging to pass cost increases onto consumers, resulting in squeezed profit margins. This inability to absorb higher prices indicates a fundamental issue. Consumers simply can't afford the inflated costs. As a result, companies tend to spend less on non-essential items, which creates a vicious cycle of falling profits and potential job losses. The manufacturing industry is usually considered a good gauge of economic well-being. Currently, the sector presents a complex picture. Although indicators for general activity and new orders indicate growth, the employment index remains negative. This contradiction suggests that there may be underlying fragility in the sector, particularly since firms are reporting no change or a decrease in employment and are beginning to reduce working hours. The situation is worrying as the job market is not growing, and along with reduced demand and increased expenses, it paints a bleak picture for the future. As unemployment increases, more and more households are struggling to pay their bills, resulting in a rise in debt rates on credit cards. As the economy struggles with these challenges, the possibility of an imminent recession could have significant consequences for the upcoming elections. A report that seemed unremarkable at first glance revealed the initial sign of an imminent economic crisis. However, on closer inspection, it uncovered a startling truth. Wage growth, once seen as a symbol of a flourishing economy, had come to a halt. This showed that salaries were not keeping pace with the rising cost of living driven by inflation. This gap between income and expenses has far-reaching effects as it reduces the purchasing power of consumers, who are the main driving force of the nation's economy. As household budgets are stretched thin, people have less money to spend, which leads to a decrease in the free flow of consumer dollars. This, in turn, affects entire industries that depend on consumer spending, negatively impacting the economy as a whole. Following the issue of stagnant wages, a new report showed that consumers are resorting to credit cards to make ends meet as they face the challenge of rising costs. This poses a potential financial burden on these individuals. Despite soaring nominal credit card balances, a closer analysis shows that real account balances, adjusted for inflation, have not yet returned to pre-pandemic levels. This suggests that consumers rely on credit to meet their basic daily needs rather than use it for extravagant purchases. This is a worrying sign of the financial difficulties many households face across the country. Other reports reveal that credit card balances have increased significantly, with a 14.3% annual growth rate in February, the highest seen since 1998. However, this might not necessarily indicate consumer confidence, as further analysis reveals that while nominal credit card balances are rising, real account balances, adjusted for inflation, remain below pre-pandemic levels. This implies that consumers are struggling to keep up with rising costs and are resorting to credit to bridge the financial gap. Also, according to a report from the Commerce Department, there was a decrease in sales, with a 0.4% drop, marking the third consecutive monthly decline. This suggests that there has been a slowdown in consumer spending, which is a crucial factor in driving economic growth. The report also highlights a shift towards online shopping, which is convenient but often results in higher prices and reduced impulse buying, further contributing to the sales slump. Recent data even revealed a significant drop in new home sales, meaning difficult times ahead for the real estate industry. This decline could cause ripple effects throughout the economy. With the increasing mortgage rates and inflated property prices, potential home buyers are finding it difficult to purchase a home. Builders, lenders, and ancillary industries face a dangerous situation as the once vibrant housing market is facing issues. The consequences of this slowdown are far-reaching and have the potential to impact everything from construction jobs to municipal tax revenues. Each economic report, taken individually, could be seen as a temporary issue in an otherwise strong economic situation. However, when viewed together, they present a more alarming picture of economic challenges that could lead to a severe and lengthy recession across the country. With stagnant wage growth, soaring consumer debt, and an unstable housing market, the foundations of the American economy are being put to the test like never before. The repercussions of these issues could be felt across all industries, from manufacturing to retail, leaving no part of the economy untouched. The possibility of a recession has been a topic of discussion among economists and policymakers for a long time. However, the latest reports have added weight to the concerns of those who have been warned about it. The signs are becoming increasingly difficult to ignore, and they all point toward a rough economy. The question is no longer whether a recession will occur, but rather when it will happen and how severe its impact will be. Will it be a brief downturn, a temporary setback on the road to recovery? Or will it be a long, drawn-out affair that tests the resilience of the American people and their leaders? We cannot afford to remain inactive in the face of overwhelming challenges. It's time to take bold and decisive measures that address the root causes of the economic crisis and pave the way for a return to stability and prosperity. This call to action applies not only to the government, but also to businesses in the private sector. They must embrace innovation and adaptability, seeking new avenues for growth and profitability in response to changing consumer dynamics. The challenges we face are significant, but they are not impossible to overcome. We can start by addressing stagnant wage growth, increasing consumer debt, and a struggling housing market to chart a path toward economic stability and renewed prosperity. Achieving this goal will require a united effort from all parties, including the government, businesses, and individuals. It will demand strong leadership, innovative thinking, and a willingness to make difficult choices to achieve long-term solutions. Individuals should also be vigilant and take proactive measures to strengthen their financial position, fostering a culture of prudence and fiscal responsibility that will allow them to withstand the downturn and emerge stronger on the other side.